Tito Wio's History in Short. A short history for the most enduring book of all time, the King James Version of the Bible, 1611. On May 2, 1611, the King James Version of the Bible, also known as the Authorized Bible, was published for the first time in London, England. It was formed because of years of resentment, disunity, and needless persecution between those who profess to be Christians. King James I of England, who was James IV of Scotland, heir to both thrones, convened the Hampton Court Conference in 1604, proposing to the formation of a new English version of the Bible in response to the perceived problems detected by the Puritans of the earlier bishops and great Bibles. The translation would be guided by an intention to limit Puritan influence, since marginal notes in the Geneva Bible was allowed with some commentaries seemingly undermining the monarchy. Such would not be made into this translation. It also must conform to the Anglican ecclesiology, retaining words that would translate as congregation to church and would lean to its episcopal structure. The base for the version was the Bishop's Bible, but problems would be filled out by Tyndale's, Coverdale, Matthew's, Great Bible, and Geneva Bible. In the recent years, scholars detected some influences from Taverner's and Douay-Rheims Bibles. 47 scholars had undertaken the task of translation, although 54 were originally approved. All were members of the Church of England and of the clergy, except Sir Henry Savile. They worked in 6 committees, 2 in each of the University of Oxford, University of Cambridge, and Westminster, 3 committees working on the Old Testament, 2 on the New Testament, and 1 on the apocryphal books. The scholars comprised of persons with Puritan sympathies and high churchmen who worked separately with their translations, then convened regularly with their committees, as the committees would also convene from time to time for comparison and harmonization. Work started on July 22, 1604. By 1608, most sections have been completed, and the Apocrypha Committee finishing first. In 1609, a General Committee of Review met. The general overseer of this work was Richard Bancroft, Archbishop of Canterbury, who died before the first printing was released. The 1611 have 2 known printing versions, called He and She Bibles, because of a line in Ruth chapter 3, verse 15, where it reads, "He went into the city, and the other, she went into the city." The Barker printer also went into serious debt for printing it, and subcontracted other printers that caused a bitter court litigation years thereafter. In 1629, Oxford and Cambridge universities also obtained licenses to print the King James Version, which they edited as Authorized Version of 1629 and 1638, introducing almost 200 revisions. On its first printing, the modern English language is undergoing spelling standardization, where V is sometimes used for U, the non-final S, and the printing of the letter thorn, rendering it like a ye instead of the. It was printed using black letter type, as it was a large volume to be used in church, not for personal devotion, although Roman type was printed in 1612. The King James Version is noted of its majesty of style, is meant to be read aloud. By 1769, the standard text was introduced to unify the version after the accumulation of wide variations in the various modernized printed texts and spellings, not to mention the notorious accumulation of misprints such as the Wicked Bible of 1631. From then on, the Oxford Standard Text, usually without the Apocrypha, is almost always the basis of current printings of the King James Version. For two centuries since its printing, the version is uncontested, deeming the Latin Vulgate's use, save for the Roman Catholics, until interest in linguistics and liberal theology gave birth to different translations, transliterations, and updates. Since the 18th century to the current century, the book had been contended by several translations and reiterations. By the second half of the 20th century, groups arise as strong adherents to use the King James only in scripture reading. Books, essays, and preachings were devised to counter the so-called deception of the devil versions. Despite other versions, the King James Version still endures for more than 400 years. By God's providence, this piece of work is one of the most printed, distributed, read, and studied, not to mention the countless souls whose hearts were changed to praise Him.